We gon' blow your own mind. When I was back home washing them dishes, I was just wishing I could just vision. I was gon' get it, I was on missions, I was just living. Walked in that building, we was just building, taking our time. We was just yielding, we was just chilling. Away from these haters, know they be watching like a theater. Plotting these niggas that we need later. They gon' be greatest, it won't delay us. This is what made us, we got Omega. Probably roll, probably just leave. I see you later, hasta luego. Cop a new crib, got some new neighbors. You get this big, they gon' want favors, they gon' want flavors. Probably roll. Hope the Lord save us, wait from these haters. Hope the Lord save us, wait from these snakes, wait from these fakes. Wait, I need breaks.
Hello everybody, I'm Larry Ridley. Welcome to the NFL on EA Sports. What a game we have for you here. The first meeting of the year between two of the NFL's most hostile divisional rivals. This matchup always among the most anticipated games of the regular season. It's the Bengals going up against the Steelers. So let's get you up to the Steel City. Standing by in Pittsburgh, here are Brandon Guyton and Charles Davis.
Right at the convergence of the Three Rivers on Art Rooney Drive, we welcome you to Heinz Field in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Today, after a crazy opening weekend, it's on to week two, and we've got a good one here between the Cincinnati Bengals and the Pittsburgh Steelers. This to the 24 for a gain of four. This offense has some speed, and certainly Martavis Bryant, he has some speed.
He has that, and he has size. That's what makes him so difficult to cover, because just when you think you have to play him one way, the other attribute kicks in. Martavis Bryant could be an all-star real soon.
Now back to throw. Quick hitter here, it's complete. That catch good for five. It's third down. And the Bengals starting defensive unit now.
Dante Fowler missed his rookie season due to injury. So good to have him back on the field. A terrific combination of speed and strength.
And just play number three here on the opening drive, and it's an early third and one.
Leopard, set, green, 39.
They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he's going to be taken down right at the line. And in their own territory, needing only a few inches, they're going to line up to go for this thing on fourth down. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. When we sat with the coaching staff a couple of days ago, they said attacking that defensive look with a run, something they wanted to do, it was effective.
And they were extremely confident, weren't they? Their planning, their preparation, they knew what they were going to get in that defense, and they were able to attack it accordingly.
So the run gets them the first, and now they operate with a fresh set of downs.
Let's go, defense. Let's go.
He'll drop to throw, and he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
It's a tried-and-true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball, and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete.
Let's go! Number 39!
He'll try again with the arm here on second down. And boy, that one drops incomplete, but if he was hit a fraction sooner, it may have been a fumble.
When defenses get to the quarterback that quickly, a lot of times it's called a jailbreak. It wasn't quite that fast, but fast enough that he had no time to look downfield and set himself to throw the ball. And as he tried to do that, he was hit and it forced an incompletion.
Watch left, watch left. Tight end to the left, tight end left.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down. The Steelers send out their punter now. As the first drive of the game stalls out, he's on to punt. Now this is fielded in the end zone. A good return there, 17 yards. And the Bengals will have a first and 10 from deep in their own territory. Start this drive in the air. Got a man over the middle, and it's complete. 19 yards that time for number 19. And he was able to find a very soft spot in that zone coverage.
I love that term, Brandon, that soft spot where you find the open area, set up, and catch the football before the hard collision comes afterwards.
So the offense has it first and 10. Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. It's brought in by Kevin White. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line.
In recent years, the slot receivers really gained stature in the NFL because they could do so many things. Yes, they can line up wide like your normal wide receiver, but to have that kind of courage and toughness to run routes in the middle of the field and become dependable targets for their quarterbacks and move the sticks, those guys are worth their weight in gold.
3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. First drive for this offense today, and our first chance to get a look at Tyler Eifert.
And he's part of the new wave of tight ends in the NFL. They use him in every position, sometimes even by themselves as a wide receiver.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down.
That play was well covered. Just tried to check it down. Unfortunately, not able to find any yardage on that one.
So a third and 8. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Throwing left side, it's complete. And he takes this one down all the way near the 30. They practiced this all week. Pretty clear it paid off there. Threw it downfield, made it look relatively easy.
And it always comes a little bit easier when you've practiced it and tuned things up and you're confident in what you're doing now. They felt very, very good about their plan, and we saw the execution because the confidence of the players was there.
Back to the ground, it's Hill. And he's going to get this one down to the 30. A gain of 3, second down. And the starting defensive unit here for Pittsburgh.
Bud Dupree came out of the University of Kentucky determined to let everyone know that they play football there as well as basketball. A terrific pass rusher off the edge.
And here comes play number 6 on this drive. To throw here. Surveying the field. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. So the long attempt falls innocently to the ground, and it brings up third.
In this situation, it's really tough to figure out how to defend because they have plenty of room to still take deep shots at the end zone as they just did there. Yet at the same time, you've got to be ready for the short throw. In this case, when you see the cue that they're going for the end zone, retreat and make sure you have a way to play forward, back towards the receiver, and have a chance to bat the ball away as they did there.
Here's play number 7 on the drive. This is 3rd and 7. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. And Adams has it, complete. And he picks up the first down yardage as he takes it down to the 16.
And fits the exact right word. Over the middle, there's almost always traffic. So anytime you're a receiver in that area, you're not just focused on catching the football. You're wondering where the collision's going to come from, right? Because there's almost always someone there able to concentrate, catch it, and even added a little extra in the end with a short run.
And his pass incomplete. Devontae Adams, the intended receiver, and it's second down.
Not too many things get to a quarterback of this magnitude, but I think it's safe to say that pressure can get to any quarterback.
Now, he's obviously a great franchise quarterback, but felt the pressure, threw it incomplete. And 2nd and 10, he'll look to throw again. On the left side, a catch by White. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's 3rd down.
Defense is going to every game talking about winning the early downs to make third down a difficult assignment for an offense. On that play, the defense accomplished its goal.
Well, just play after play after play on this long drive for the offense. On third down, he'll drop to throw. Eluding the pressure right. He can run for it, and he will. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. They'll give him a yard on the play, and that's going to bring up a fourth down.
Well, partner, nothing comes open here, so he decides to escape out of there, and he doesn't pick up a first down, but he does gain additional yardage to set up a possible field goal attempt if they decide to go that route.
And, Charles, they get the field goal. Took him a dozen plays, though.
Work with me on this one. You know what I'm about to say, right? Bend but don't break. That's what came into play here for the defense. 12 plays were run at them. They only gave up 3 points. In a lot of ways, that's a win for the defense.
It's a very short kick, taken right at the 20. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. The Steelers' offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. And last time out, they had to punt the football away. Anything positive possibly to take from that?
There always is when you're punting the football away. It doesn't sound like it because you're giving it up. But you've avoided a mistake.
At least you didn't turn it over.
You didn't turn it over, right? You're giving your defense a chance because you're punting the ball away and they're set to go on the field as opposed to sudden change after a turnover. And wow, now we've got to go out there and stop people. So, yeah, there's always something positive to be gained from it.
See if they stay on the ground for second down.
Here we go now.
He'll drop to throw. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
As tight ends go, he might not provide the super flashy plays very often, but he's pretty reliable, usually an excellent target, and normally catches what's thrown to him, but he didn't on that play.
Looking to throw. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Khalil Mack. And his guys will take over at the 30-yard line. Now the Cincinnati offense ready to see what they can do here. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 point.
The kicker.
Exactly. You put it through the post, that's going to help him in contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him in contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that.
Bash, dude.
Super toe. Seeing that play and understand just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice game right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
Underneath here to Hill. And he takes it down to the 10-yard line. It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives him a first and goal. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage, if he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because they'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
And on second and 10 now. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. This will be caught at the 2. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down. Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin, and it's the Bengals with a football to begin quarter number 2. And they'll come up looking to keep this drive moving. Knocking on the door as they come to the line here on third and goal from the 1. They'll try and sneak it here. And he is in. Touchdown, Bengals. It's their quarterback. His first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Bengals add on to their lead. So he's able to sneak it in, and credit to the guys up front.
Oh, without a doubt, because they have the leverage on this play. We always talk about low man wins and one-on-one battles. That's exactly what happened there. Their offensive line, lower than the defensive front.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
Cleo Mack's starting to get a really big-time reputation as a pass rusher, and rightly so. So explosive off the edge, getting to the quarterback. But he doesn't neglect his run duties as well. How about that tackle right there? Such a package he has, able to play the run and the pass so well. When you see passes knocked down by those guys I call the frustrated fullbacks, the linebackers, you know that in their zone coverage, they were able to drop, see the ball thrown, and react to it very quickly.
They'll come out in the pistol. He'll look to throw. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. Trying to get it there to Martavis Bryant. And it's fourth down. The Steelers send out their punter now. On for his second punt. He'd take a repeat of his first. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. That's taken on the 25. A very good return there. Give him an even 20 yards. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. Cincinnati now ready to take the field. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They might have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out.
It's grabbed over the middle by White. And a nice gain of 21 yards. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful? You're losing, playing against a good quarterback like he is, to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, go to a zone blitz scheme. And you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield. Let's make this one simple. What a catch, especially the finishing part of getting his feet in bounds, toe tapping, and of course, foot dragging.
A little tapestry, if you will.
Oh, I like it.
Forced out to his left. Touchdown, Bengals! And maybe the defense got so caught up in him throwing the football, they forgot he can take off, too.
And you often hear about the quarterback being the unaccounted for guy as a runner. Well, even on a passing play, he's unaccounted for as a runner, and he turned it into a nice game.
A very nice run, and it turns in to 6 points. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This will be fielded at the 8. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And 3 and out on the last drive. No points on the scoreboard. A little soul searching now.
I would say so, and they need to help out their defense a little bit. They've had to be on the field a lot more than normal, put them in some tough spots. But what's the old adage? When you get another chance, it gives you a better chance to do it right.
All right, here we go.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. He's going to launch, and now this is intercepted. My goodness. A great read, and it's picked off. And his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line. Cincinnati now ready to take the field. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them. They feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go-around. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield, complete. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Right, right, right.
first down. He'll drop to throw. He's got White here. And this time not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line. Give him 9 on the play, and that'll make it second and short. Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. On second down, Hill. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. The tackle there by Eli Harrell.
That was an example of excellent defense there. They stuffed him. So now he brings up a third down situation.
And he will not make it back to the line of scrimmage as he's going to be taken down. It'll go in the books as a sack and a loss of a yard. But more importantly, it leads to fourth down. So they'll pass on what would have been a 49-yard field goal attempt, and they're going for it on fourth down. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he's going to have a first down here as he gets this one to the 17-yard line.
Well, the field goal attempt was well in hand. They had that, but they decided to go for it anyway. Extreme confidence, it looks like.
Yeah, but I bet the defense is going to remember this one, right? They kind of rubbed their nose in it. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. They come out 5 wide, 3 of them to the right side. They'll drop the throw, and he slings one that's incomplete.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Looks like the defense in press coverage here.
Here we go.
He'll try again with the arm here on second down. Steps away to his left. And his throw is going to be incomplete. Tyler Croft, the tight end, the one he was looking for. And it's third down. They got pressure there and only rushing 3.
And there's a defensive coordinator right now who is celebrating not just getting home with 3 there, but realizing if that's the type of pressure he can get in the entire game, then his pass defense is going to be excellent. You're dropping 8. Where are you going to go with the football?
All right, here we go.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. And Eifert has it. He didn't get the touchdown, but he did get the first down as he's tackled at the 1.
I'd have to say they're feeling like they are in rhythm right now. Things are in sync, aren't they? Team's winning, got a nice little margin on the scoreboard, completing some passes, and they just completed another one for a first down there to the tight end.
And he takes it into the end zone. Touchdown, Bengals. It's their quarterback on his way to a monster game. 3 first-half touchdowns, and the Bengals are able to grow their lead. And this one through the uprights and good. The kicking team out now for the Bengals as they'll send this one away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And last time wasn't pretty. 1 play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. They come out here in the eye. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be 2nd and 8.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. 2nd and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
They'll set up a throw. He's going to float this one deep right side. And they went for a big play through the air on 2nd down. Couldn't connect. Now it's 3rd.
Sure, that pass was incomplete as they made an attempt to get a big one downfield. But that's okay because the second part of that is if you don't get the completion, at least you've told the defense you're trying to stretch them out a little bit and they may have to change accordingly.
So a 2nd down incompletion now brings up 3rd down. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And for the 3rd time here this half, it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And they take over. They'll set up shop at the 46-yard line. So now the Bengal offensive unit back out onto the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were competent enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went. No adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Ball hit as he throws there, incomplete.
The good signal callers would never go back in the huddle and play the blame game, because they need those guys to protect him. But on that last one, his offensive line, they lost their leverage very quickly, and that's why they were able to get to him and hit him as he tried to throw the football and force an incompletion.
Out of the gun now on third down. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. It's a gain of 20 and picking up the first.
We always hear about the connections some quarterbacks have with certain receivers. I think this guy has a connection with just about everyone. Didn't mind throwing it in there against double coverage to him.
Shows some confidence, supreme confidence.
Big time confidence that he would make the play for him, and he did.
Now a first down carry, it's Hill. And he's going to push his way down to about the 12. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1. 2 minutes to play here in the first half. Back to Heinz Field after this. Just 1 yard to go here on 2nd down. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. This will be caught just inside the 10. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Bengal TD. Their dangerous wide receiver. His first touchdown of the new season. And the Bengals have got it on cruise control. And they're able to up the lead by 1 more. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Pittsburgh's offense now heading back out onto the field. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities. It's always tough trying to keep your guy upright when he's trying to throw the football. When you're dealing with those big, bad guys on the defensive front, it's even tougher. And this time, those guys on the opposite side won the battle, getting to the quarterback and knocking him into an incompletion.
And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up 3rd down.
Oh, man. For him to be that wide open and drop it. Sometimes you have just too much time on your hands, right? You end up thinking way too much, and your hands get shaky.
And yes, he's a tight end, but that's a catch he should have made. Going for the deep ball. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
On every offensive coordinator, every play caller sheet, they have about 5 or 6 plays per game that they call shot plays or big plays, and you don't get many opportunities to dial them up, and they just did. And they drop it with a great chance to make a big play. That's going to hurt.
Call it a 48-yard punt. Give them 9, though, on the return. And the Bengals take possession. Now the Cincinnati offense ready to see what they can do here. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good. So they'll be hoping to do that once more.
And it takes me back to when we sat with the offense coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that. He's got a man that's caught left sideline. And he takes it down deep into Pittsburgh territory. A big play there for Cincinnati. 55 yards. 1st down and 10 now for the offensive group. Now back to throw. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. It's a gain of 9 yards. And it'll be second and about a yard.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
They'll come out in the pistol. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Dancing to his left. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure if something goes wrong.
And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. A great read, and it's picked off. And they will take over at the 26-yard line. Cincinnati now ready to take the field. And they had a nice little drive going last time through the interception in the red zone. Costly.
Bad enough to throw it anywhere, but that drives coaches insane when they're thinking about, hey, we got a shot at points already. We're already in a spot where you're thinking you got three on the board for sure, and to come away with nothing, that's a really tough one for them to swallow.
Yeah. Will they make up for it? They'll set up to throw. Escaping the pressure right. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. Now, whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. They'll look to throw now on first down. And that is caught. He's got it for a Bengal touchdown. Tyler Eifert, as the first half is winding down, and the Bengals just continue to pour it on. And the rout is on here in this first half. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. And now out come the Steelers. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Throwing right, and that's complete. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Good use of the pass there to pick up the first down against a defensive look that they had specifically prepared for, they told us, coming into this one.
Certainly seems like they're holding all the right cards now, doesn't it? Because of their preparation. Went back, watched the tape, studied the tendencies, and they felt like they had them down cold, and they were able to use the pass against them.
So we have reached halftime here, and it's the visiting Bengals out in front as we'll send you down to Orlando where Larry Ridley has our EA Sports halftime report. Larry, both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Bengal offense now with a football first here to begin quarter number three. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. Caught on the right side by Adams. Now after that last play, there's a Bengal down on the field. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break. Throw now on first down. It's grabbed over the middle by White. And he's finally taken down, but not before getting across midfield and across the 45-yard line. They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, Why not go back to it? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
So he got three and one tackle, but couldn't do a whole lot else. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws.
And he's going to be taken down. Back across midfield, just across midfield at the 49. Boy, he came in off the edge so quickly there.
Look out, because that's exactly what it was being shouted by the offensive lineman to his quarterback because he had no chance to block it.
Second down, sacked by the defense. What type of pressure will they bring here on third? We'll see. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. He'll rifle this one deep right side. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down. The Bengals bring out their punter now, as he should be able to pin him back deep here with his first punt.
Well, they went for the big play there, but that drop could really hurt their momentum.
And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. And this will be out of bounds. Now it's a question of where they'll mark it. And they'll say it crosses at the 11-yard line. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the stop defensively. Now a chance really to set the tone here in quarter three.
They can really take charge, can't they? And this is probably how it was drawn up at the half. I think we can go inside the locker room, all right? And I think we would see up on the grease boards, stop them defensively, get the ball back for the offense, and let's go downfield and score. Seems simple, right? The last part, we have to find out that's going to happen. But the first part worked to perfection. Did exactly what they wanted, and now their offense has to pay it off.
See if they can get the latter 50%. On first down, it dropped to throw. Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
That was well defended, and while it was a completion, it resulted in a loss of yardage. It's really, really hard for a running back to think to himself, I probably should have just dropped it and saved the yardage. It goes against the entire training that he's had his whole career.
Here we go now.
They'll drop the throw. Wide open receiver complete. Going again at 19, and it moves the chains. And the offense moving quickly to the line. And that's one of his advantages of a passer, is it not, with his height, setting back there in the pocket, firing over the middle. He can really see everything. And my goodness, another interception. A great read, and it's picked off. And he's going to get this one to the 23-yard line. Now this Bengals offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. They've got the lead. Last time had to punt it, though. What's the key to this drive?
I think it's leverage. Big guys up front. You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer, create space for our runners, and let's go ahead and get these guys. Low man wins. Let's go do it on this drive.
We'll watch that leverage on this drive. Flush to his right. Sideline throw. It's complete. And a nice job there of keeping the toes in bounds. He's been a busy man here in this one, and they're showing off some nice footwork to stay in bounds.
And with those types of catches and the volume that we've seen in this game, wouldn't you keep him busy as well?
I would.
Of course. You got to keep throwing it to him. He keeps making plays.
All right, here we go. Green, 39. Green.
Now they'll throw here out of the gun. Looking for his tight end, Eifert, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line. The Steelers' offense now, they head back onto the field. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back out there was, don't do that again. What do you think?
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that. I think that not only did he say that, but he also told them, let's put it in the end zone that it's supposed to be in, all right? The end zone we're trying to score. I know we're being a little bit facetious here, but the bottom line is take care of the football, and everything else should flow from there.
Quick lesson, never ask the play-by-play guy a question.
Hey, you're my partner. I know you're right there with me.
And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down.
Well, we're not playing 3 yards in the cloud of dust football anymore. I kind of get why those old school coaches sometimes didn't want to throw the football. Because if it's popped up in the air, it almost turns into slow motion. And both sides trying to get to the football. And you're holding your breath wondering whether it's going to go good or bad for your team.
And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete. And he's certainly not a guy that drops that football very often.
Indeed, because that's a bit of a surprise. I know he's in the middle of some traffic and people, bodies all around him, but he usually has the focus to haul that one in.
And he comes back with one complete. It'll be a gain of 8, but it'll also lead to a 4th down. Still just the 3rd quarter, but they've got to make something happen. I think they know that. They're going for it on 4th. And he will find his man on the end route. Complete. 6 yards on the pickup, and they're able to pick up the conversion here on 4th down.
We always talk about big-time players make big-time plays and big-time moments. I think that 4th down qualified. That was a heck of a throw.
Inside 4 minutes to go, 3rd quarter. Now a play fake here on 1st down. And this is caught at the 8. And he's in. Touchdown, Steelers. Their big tight end. His first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Steelers are able to get a score back. So they get one score back, but still a long ways to go here in this 3rd quarter. Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. Not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Cincinnati now ready to take the field. They come out 5 wide, 3 of them to the right side. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Well, the numbers have been good in the passing game and certainly a big reason why they have the lead. But now here, 3rd quarter, maybe go to the run game a little more?
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, after that incompletion, a little credit to the defense for shutting them down on that play. Maybe you try and run the football a little bit more in this spot. But they have to feel good about how they've been throwing it overall.
And 2nd and 10, he'll look to throw again. Going down the middle, and it's complete. A good pickup there, 26 yards. And the offense lining up 1st and 10.
Single receiver, hey, you're on an island over there.
They come up in an offset eye.
Hurry up, here we go. Green, 39.
They'll look to throw now on 1st down. That's complete to White. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
They'll look to throw here on 1st down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Stephon Tuitt coming up the middle, gets him there for a loss of about 9. To throw. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up 3rd down.
Looked like they had an opportunity for a big play across the middle, but he didn't have the concentration or the focus necessary and dropped it before he could haul it in.
Here we go now.
Out of the gun now on 3rd down. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. He could not get away that time, and it'll be a loss of 11 on 3rd down.
And that's the 2nd sack of the game, but this player, disruptive in all phases, whether he's going upfield, coming underneath, you name it, he's a big-time guy you have to block.
Out of bounds as he appeared to be looking for the corner. He got it. They're going to mark this at the 4-yard line. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. Last time they were out, they scored. Still trailing here, though, so some work to do.
but it's okay in terms of mindset. Because they scored the last time, they're not quite as worried about being down on the scoreboard because now their confidence is a little bit higher. They feel like they've got something going, and they feel like they can attack again and put more points on the board.
Are you scoreboard watching if you're the offense, or are you just focused on this drive?
We wouldn't be telling the truth if we said that they didn't scoreboard watch. Everyone does it to some extent, but you've got to set it aside right now and just focus on this series. That'll take care of the scoreboard if they punch it into the end zone.
So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down.
Here we go now. Three. No. Check. Patriot.
Now they try the right side here. And he'll be taken down, losing yardage back at the 9-yard line. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
With the struggles we're seeing up front for the offense today, they've got to think about changing up their play calling. Some screens, some draws, some quick hitting plays in order to try and supplement the run game. You don't totally abandon it, but you try and give it a little bit of help.
All right, here we go.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And it's a short one here, complete to his tight end. Call it a gain of 10, and they pick up the first.
They were full-scale, loose, flexible, finding a way to catch the ball in some traffic for a key first down.
Yeah, really a nice job of adjusting to the ball in the air. Not the most accurate of throws, but able to adjust and make the grab.
Back to throw now on first down. Over the middle, and it's incomplete. Offense looking to avoid a third and long. It's second and 10. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. And a quick throw here. That's complete. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. Now this will probably be the last play of the quarter. Back now in Pittsburgh. It's the Steelers with the football, but trailing here as we get going in quarter number four. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively.
All right, now look at 56. Look at 56.
They come out here in the eye. They'll give it to him right up the gun. And he's going to have the first down yardage as he's down at about the 30-yard line.
I always appreciate runners who understand situations. That was just third and inches. No reason to dance around in the backfield and try and break off a bigger play. Just go pick up the first down, and that's exactly what he did.
And they get 28 yards on that one. And it's good enough for a Pittsburgh first down. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height, sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can stay in there if he's willing to take the hits and just fire over the top, which saves him time and actually completes a play a little bit quicker than it normally does for a quarterback that has to slide and find open space to throw.
Still left on second down. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. Back to throw now on second and 10. Bryant with a catch right side. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. This will be play number 9 of the drive here as they need 4 yards on third down. Back to throw again. And he's got it. Got his man on the end route. Complete. And he's going to get the first down as they bring him down at the 23. And now they're in the hurry up.
And Brandon, from my time in college football, where receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree, one thing they did learn, find open areas, find soft spots, and set up and catch the ball. And I think we just saw that there.
Yeah, we saw that indeed, picking up the first.
Long drive. The defense just cannot seem to catch a break and get off the field. He'll try again with the arm here on second down. He's going to let it go deep for the end zone. Oh, he almost had it for the pick. A great chance there for the interception in the end zone. Instead, third down. So a ways to go here on third and 10. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And now here is another interception. A great read, and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. The Bengal offense now gets set to head back out onto the field. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to.
And a loose football. And it's picked up by the Steelers. And his guys will take over at the 30-yard line. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. Looked like they had something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory they need to keep with them is that they did have something going. They were moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence going. Don't worry about the other part. You can't get that back. Let's go back to what you were doing well before.
I thought you were going to say they need to have no memory, but remember the good part, forget the bad.
I like that even better.
And his throw is incomplete.
How many times when we see an incomplete pass, we just look at the receiver and say, should have caught that one. That was a drop, and we just put it on the offense. How about a little credit for the defense there? They just forced an incompletion.
Yeah, especially after starting in a tough spot defensively, but a good start there on first down.
That gave them a little extra confidence there, starting, as you said, in a tough spot and being able to make a play on first down.
They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. Out left side here to Bryant. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up.
That looked like a pretty good route combination there, because you've got to find a way to clear the guy running the drag. Because when you...
And the ball is knocked out, and the Bengals grab it. And some space here. And he's able to get it back to right around the 27. The Bengals offense now, they head back onto the field. And a fumble last time. Ball security. Talk about it all the time in the National Football League. They've got to be better at it on this drive.
Don't you think that when every team gets together for the first time, I don't care if it's OTAs, mini camps, first day of camp in the regular season, ball security comes up about, the second sentence of the coach's address?
And those are so many drills focus on that.
All the time, and they do drills to make it even tougher to simulate game situations. Doesn't always work out, though.
They begin the drive with Hill. Able to shake free for about seven up to the 35. Well, they'll take that every time with a lead, first down, fourth quarter, getting 8 yards. You love that.
They will take it, and you have to ask the defensive guys, why did you give it? I mean, you know the situation. You're down, have to stop them, have to get the football back. But 8 yards on first down puts them back on their heels.
Of the gun. They'll look to throw. A dump off now to Hill. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. Calling a gain of seven, and it gets him a new set of downs.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
To throw here on first down. Flushed out right. Underneath here to Hill. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
They'll look to throw now on first down. Quick hitter here. It's complete. A gain of six there on first.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
They'll look to throw again. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
And he still doesn't have a catch. We're into the second half. I think it's a little bit of a surprise to me, but that was one he should have caught.
Absolutely. That was his best opportunity right there. He dropped it. Third down and four. To throw again. He hits White, complete, and all the way in for a Cincinnati score. Kevin White, his second touchdown on the season, and the Bengals have got it on cruise control. And my friend, I think it's safe to say that this game is pretty much deceased at this point. It's taken a knee, so to speak.
It is definitely this victory formation. Take the snap, take the knee, call it a night, you know, call it a game, call it whatever. I agree with you totally. I don't think there's much left to get except for those who want to run up the score.
I knew this was over about a minute ago when you took your stat sheet and just flipped it over your shoulder in the trash can.
Yeah, that's similar to the guys cutting tape off right before the game's over. We know this thing's done.
Check 26. Here we go. Green, 39.
They'll try and start this drive in the air. It's caught by Bryant. And they're able to get this one across the 35. A nice pick up there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks. And they're going to speed things up here.
It's a nice completion, a little bit of run after catch as well to grade the yardage that they got. But it is so tough to cover that route, the drag route, because they run it at varying speeds. Because the key is...
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. So following the penalty, now first and five. They're going to look to throw. And Bryant's got it over the middle. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40. And quickly, they get to the line. He had time, was able to survey the field and find a soft spot in that zone coverage.
And that's where it gets difficult for a defender, Brandon. You go to your spots on the field that you have to cover, and when the offense finds an area that you're not in, that's where they throw the football.
And he's been one of their few bright spots here this afternoon.
And as you pointed out, so far he's gotten his. That's not been the issue at all. But the teammates, the other guys, they've been shut down. That's why the defensive guys have to feel pretty good, even though he's over 100 yards.
Yeah, he topped 100 with that last catch. So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. Second down and 10. Again, he'll drop to throw. And that is caught. Well, they're going to see this one to the end. They get a score, but pretty much an exercise in futility right now. Still down big.
Well, I do have one word for that touchdown for you, partner. You ready?
Yeah.
Cosmetics.
Just makes things look a little better. I don't know. It's like putting lipstick on a pig.
Yeah, and it's hard to do, too. And the pig doesn't like the lipstick a heck of a lot. But you do like the fact that they're battling down the stretch, still trying to put something on the board, even though this game is over.
By the way, how rude is that to the pig? Look at all the things they give us. Pulled pork, bacon. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. The Bengals getting set to go. Good drive last time. Really effective passing the football. Do you maybe mix it up, now go to the ground game and surprise the defense a little bit?
I would anticipate the defense making some changes, but I wouldn't necessarily just absolutely go in the opposite direction. They're doing so well throwing the ball.
Yeah, why
I wouldn't change it up until they showed me a reason to do so.
Able to shake him off. He's going to fire one deep, middle of the field. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. A great read, and it's picked off. And his guys are going to take over at the 31-yard line. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And they're hoping to capture some of that magic they had last time out when they were able to put together a scoring drive. But they're still down here, Charles.
Not the major concern, though, because of what you talked about. They scored the last time out. They feel good about themselves. They feel like their game plan is now in effect. They know how to attack and what plays they want to put together. But they've got to keep it moving in the right direction because, as you did note, they are down on the scoreboard.
And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. The completion good for three, and it's second down.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the first tackle. Luckily enough, there were more people there to get him down.
Now it's second and seven. And they're going to go soft on the corners. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. That time they hit him out of the slot on the drag.
And that route takes some fortitude from the guy running it because he knows he's going through the briar patch, as I like to call it, right? He's trying to work his way through all that traffic and people wanting to put a little contact on him. Really well done.
He'll look to throw. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
So much of his game is focus and concentration. And whenever I see guys running the in route, I know that in the back of their mind, they're always wondering who's lurking inside that might put a big hit on them as they try and catch the ball.
They're already slim hopes are going to ride on this one. They'll go on fourth down. Got to try it here. He's back to throw. And it is incomplete. The Steelers try it, but they come up empty on fourth down. And the Bengals are going to get it back in terrific field position. And out now, here come the Bengals. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling. Because a one-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give them a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
Eluding the pressure right. Caught on the right side by Adams. Time for a break. Back to finish it off on EA Sports after this. Fresh set of downs here.
Watch left, tight end to the left, tight end left.
All right, here we go.
That one looks like he'll throw here. And he couldn't hang on. Would have been their fourth pick of the game. Instead, second down.
A missed opportunity for an interception would have killed off a drive. They had a chance there to finish things off. Didn't get it done. I guess that's why a lot of those guys do not play offense.
So second and 10 here.
I got tripped this side. I got tripped this side. We got three. Here we go.
Now they'll throw here out of the gun. And that one almost intercepted. Far too loose with the football here. Nearly a fourth pick. And it's third down.
Well, an incomplete pass certainly doesn't look like a good play. For the guy throwing it today, as many interceptions he's thrown, he's got to feel a sigh of relief that the ball actually hit the ground and didn't go in the other direction. The Steelers insert their nickel defense on third down.
Yeah, they add a DB. He'll drop to throw. And that's incomplete. So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. He connected on his first. This time it's 39 yards away. And his kick here is good. And they're sitting pretty now as the lead grows even further. So it's three more points, and that widens things out even further here in the fourth.
Hey, in this league, you can never have too much. So if you're in range, grab the three whenever you can.
And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. They are just obviously getting shellacked here in this one, Charles. What's the message if you're a coach for this final drive in a lopsided game like this?
For a lot of coaches,
be honest.
Don't forget today. Don't forget what has happened out here.
Yeah, use that as ammo
exactly.
Going forward.
Exactly. Take a great look at that scoreboard. Realize how poorly everything went for us today. Coaching, playing, the whole deal. And never forget it. Because
you're not going to want that feeling again.
No, you don't want that feeling again. And who knows? You may meet up with this team again.
Looking to speed things up here. Going with some tempo. They'll look to throw here on first down. He's going to let it fly. He's got it at the 15. And somewhat of a measure of revenge as he's in for the touchdown, but they still trail big time.
He'll take it, but he won't be able to smile about it.
And correct me if I'm wrong, that was just a simple fly route, wasn't it?
No, there's nothing to correct at all. You've got it down pat. And I just remember as a player, when I'd be in practice sessions and I'd hear 9 from the receivers, that meant fly route, go, look out. That was the 9, and he just kept going all the way into the end zone for the touchdown.
And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. So now the Bengal offensive unit back out onto the field. They come into enemy territory, and I don't care what the matchup is in the National Football League. You're up like this late in the game on the road. This feels pretty good.
Oh, it feels fantastic. Anytime you get a road victory in the NFL, that's a big-time accomplishment, and to do it this convincingly, that just tears up the script that every home team has, which is nobody comes into our house and pushes us around. They took care of business today.
Yeah, they pushed around, and now the final stages of this one. So the incomplete pass brings up second down. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Buying time to his left. Now he'll turn and throw deep back to the other side of the field. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
Well, the obvious goal is to try and score a touchdown, but at the least, adding to a pretty big yardage total for his intended receiver there, huh?
Yeah, when you got a guy over 150 yards, keep chucking it deep to him, I guess.
Yeah, no doubt about it. You can get it to him short, and he can make plays that way. But I like what you just said. Throw it to him deep and get it in a big chunk.
But incomplete on that try. What? Now the Steelers put a stop to the action with a timeout defensively. It's just their first. They've got 2 more to use here in the final stages. The Bengals bring out their punter now as he'll come on to kick this one away. And taken right on the 30. He can't bring him down.
The weight room does work.
They'll score that a 36-yard punt. And the Steelers will go on offense here, first and 10. Pittsburgh's offense now heading back out onto the field. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride?
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares? Let's get out of here and do something some other time." But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better
as they continue to
move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them.
I wouldn't be surprised to see the next step in utilizing this position is to actually utilize more of a scat back in this spot, because we saw the catch there, right? He made it. He's a bigger, stronger guy, maybe not quite as elusive as maybe someone else you would put
there. Yeah, didn't get the big yardage there you might out of a smaller back. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
We just saw another example of really good defensive football, which has led to the cushion that they have in this game. Got to him once again, knocked him on the ground, forced an incompletion.
Yeah, they've set the tone. It's one thing to set the tone, another to come in here on the road and set the tone. The Bengals with 2 extra DBs, a nickel look on third.
Blanketing the passing lanes.
Now a desperation throw deep downfield, and that will be incomplete. 4 ticks left here on the clock.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out.
Hurry up, here we go.
One final shot. They'll look to throw. He's going to let it fly. And this is caught inside the 5. And into the end zone. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. Their big-bodied
wide receiver with two touchdowns on the season, both in this game. And the Steelers are able to close the gap just a bit. And that'll make this a 19-point game. Well, on the one side, if you try to take away something positive from this game, they played to the final whistle, getting the touchdown there on the last play. But still, all for naught, really.
Yeah, I'd say give them points for positivity. I like that. That part is good. But I often wonder, when the game is settled and the clock has run out, do we really need to kick the extra point?
Oh, yeah. It's silly.
It doesn't make any sense to me. I know that people have explained before, well, you got to play it all the way through. Come on, this thing was done.
So for the Bengals, it was a great all-around performance as they come out of this one with the victory. And they'll return home next week to take on the New England Patriots. Meanwhile, for the Steelers, they will fall to 1-1. And they'll be on the road next week for a matchup with the Baltimore Ravens. So that'll do it for us. For my partner, Charles Davis, and all the hard-working men and women on our crew, I'm Brandon Gaughan. You've been watching the NFL right here on EA Sports. With that, we sign off from Heinz Field.
Killing it, yeah. I've been hard in the paint, not a single assist. Yeah, I've been flicking that wrist. Yeah, I've been that they with this. Yeah, I've been killing it, yeah. I've been hard in the paint, not a single assist. Yeah, I've been flicking that wrist. Yeah, I've been that they with this. Yeah, I've been killing that, yeah. I've been flicking that wrist. Yeah, I've been killing that, flicking that wrist. Yeah, I've been killing that, yeah. I've been hard in the paint, not a single assist. Yeah, I've been flicking that wrist, flicking that, killing that, flicking that wrist. Let me tell you about the young man. Matter of fact, I'ma let put